San Diego's Old Town was the first European settlement in all of California, created in 1769 with a mission and a fort. The Kumeyaay people had lived here for thousands of years and saw how San Diego became the city we know today. James Robinson and his wife Sarah built a house in 1853, which also served as the town's law office. It later had other functions like medical offices and the county clerk's office. In 1868, Robinson's widow sold it to Lewis Rose for $10,000 in gold coins. The reconstruction serves as Old Town's visitor center. James McCoy built this two-story house in 1869 as a gift to his wife, Winifred. Its stature and size showed his prominence as sheriff and later as a state senator. The Casa de Machado and Wrightington was home to Juana, a midwife, and Thomas, a shoemaker. It was built in the 1830s and by 1858 was used as an office by George W. McKinstry, who previously assisted in rescuing the Donner Party and now served as the combination dentist, physician, and sheriff of San Diego. La Casa de Machado y Stuart was built south of Old Town's Washington Square in 1835. As with most adobes, the structure was constructed with ridge poles secured with rawhide strips on the overhead frame. It originally had a living room and a bedroom. 11 children were raised in the house, and their descendants continued to live here until 1966. La Casa de Machado y Silvas was built on the south side of Washington Square in the 1840s. A decade later, the Casa was converted into the commercial restaurant. Adjacent to it is the slightly taller Casa de Rodriguez. It was a one-room adobe built about 1830 by Juan Rodriguez, a former Presidio soldier. In 1869, two Canadians, Alexis Racine and Charles Laramie, turned it into a general store for tobacco. Casa de Carrillo is historical landmark number 74. Repurposed like many buildings in Old Town, it's the pro shop for the Presidio Hills Golf Course. It was completed by 1821, and this remaining section has stood for over two centuries. With the exception of missions, it's considered one of the oldest standing structures in San Diego County. It's amusing they have satellite TV. Francisco Maria Ruiz built this house for his relative, Joaquin Carrillo, in order to be close to his pear orchard, which existed here way back in 1808. This bell tower overlooks Old Town's Washington Square on top of La Casa de Estudio. As you walk through the entrance corridor, you see it opens up into a central garden with a fountain and plants. Many of them are suited for the mildly dry southwestern climate, such as the different cacti. Built from 1827 to 1829, La Casa de Estudio is one of the larger mansions, with adobe structures on three sides surrounding the garden. The kitchen was one of the 12 rooms and provided the means to prepare and store meals. Fish and seafood could be caught from the nearby ocean, and the adobe helped to keep things cool in the summer months. The Estudios were a prosperous family and could afford to host guests with their accommodations. See how their dining room had fine china and silverware with ample room for a large gathering. One of the bedrooms shows two cribs and a bed with a nightstand and closet furnishings. Old Town didn't have a church until 1858. This altar in Casa de Estudio served as a place for traveling priests to perform baptisms, weddings, and memorial services. Some of the space was rented out as a store. Household wares, personal items, and medicinal products were sold to the inhabitants and those that journeyed into Old Town. Another bedroom was needed, In addition to their 9 children, the Estudillos adopted 2 more, took in 2 orphans from the wife's sister, and added 4 grandchildren. In 1887, John D. Spreckles turned the house into Ramona's marriage place, based on the book Ramona by Helen Hunt Jackson. In 1968, it was restored back to its original state as a house. Named after the Colorado River, the Colorado House was built by Cave Coots in 1851. It's the first 2-story hotel in San Diego. Like many properties in Old Town, it also housed several different businesses, such as a surgeon, a hairdresser, and a jewelry shop. In 1841, this section with the ceramic roof was converted into a store and saloon. It was named San Diego House by the African-American owners Richard Freeman and Alan Light. The sign says tinsmith, specializing in candle holders, lamps, and lanterns. This modern store resides in the U.S. House. It was prefabricated and assembled in 1850 and became the U.S. restaurant 2 decades later. In 1869, the Pedro Rena Altamirano House was built as one of the last adobe houses, including some modern wood frame construction. Today, it houses miners' gems for rocks, fossils, and jewelry. As with many Old Town buildings, it has been restored relatively recently in 1982. Built in 1865, the Mason Street School was the first public school in San Diego County. All 8 grades were taught at the same time. From behind the teacher's desk, the room is currently configured with 3 benches. You can see the potbelly stove in the back, which provided heat in the winter. The most prominent bright pink building was established as Casa de Bandini in the late 1820s. It served as an olive factory, restaurant, and is now known as the Cosmopolitan Hotel. In 1869, Albert Seeley purchased it to establish his stagecoach business, as this sign suggests. Next to it, Seeley constructed this barn to stable horses and store stagecoaches for his transportation outfit between here and Los Angeles. There were a couple donkeys in the corral, enjoying the San Diego sun and fresh air. The Black Hawk livery stable was purchased by Albert Seeley in 1871 and enabled him to take care of his horses and perform maintenance on the carriages. You see the roofed area for working on wagons, as well as the one-of-a-kind Tustin windmill in the field to pump water, and the blacksmith shop. This windmill was designed to pivot into the wind 360 degrees and pumped water from below for livestock and stables. As we walk toward the blacksmith shop, it becomes apparent that all manner of tools and parts were needed to maintain and run a stagecoach operation. Anvils, chains, clamps, hammers, and a whole assortment of others can be seen throughout. We see the frame of a covered wagon that has been bent into shape. Here is the large bellows and anvils to forge steel and iron. We see the abundance of tools, as having the right tool makes a job easier. It's best to have an on-site blacksmith, too. 2 useful tools were used to shape iron tires onto the wooden wheels. This is an iron tire bender to yield a circular shape. This one is an iron tire shrinker to tighten and reduce its circumference as wear loosened its hold on a wooden wheel. Just behind this wagon, with its iron tires and wooden wheels, is the Johnson House, built with a wooden frame structure in 1869. It has a front porch and was used as a grocery store in the 1870s. If you listen closely, you may hear drumming. The Rust General Store is what used to be the Alvarado House, built around 1830. The drumming is slightly louder now. The Alvarado Saloon currently houses Casa Kumeyaay Market. The Kumeyaay Nation are the original inhabitants indigenous to the San Diego area. Archaeological evidence points to their existence here even 12,000 years ago. To put that into perspective, they have lived here 7,500 years before the Great Pyramids of Giza were built. Another way to say it is that they are, and have been, the first people of this land for 600 generations. The Whaley House describes itself as America's most haunted house. The Whaley family themselves told the local newspaper of a poltergeist they thought was Yankee Jim Robinson, who had been hanged on the property prior to building of the house in 1857. Yankee Jim was a miner with a reputation of murdering others for their gold and trinkets. He was 6'4" with an imposing figure. One day, he and two others stole a boat from Joseph Stewart and Enos Wall. The boat was recovered a few days later, and the three thieves were arrested and tried for grand larceny. Yankee Jim did not object that the two boat owners were on the jury. Here's the 1851 San Diego Union Building, where the Tribune later recounted the story of Yankee Jim. He expected the owners to go easy on him since they found the boat. Yankee Jim overestimated their charity. In August of 1852, he was found guilty of grand larceny and sentenced to hanging the next month. Until then, he was kept at the county jail. The first San Diego courthouse was built in 1847 as the first fired brick structure in San Diego. Yankee Jim didn't stay at the courthouse, but more likely in something like the tiny jail cell out in the back. It was all metal and wood construction. The accommodations, bare minimum. Only walls and iron bars to keep him company. At least Yankee Jim could be thankful for San Diego's mild climate. From inside a cage, a bleak existence behind the courthouse. And after he died, a ghostly existence inside the Whaley House. El Campo Santo, the Holy Field Cemetery, buried 477 people over the early years of Old Town. Several grave sites are outside the wall of the cemetery, underneath the sidewalk and street of San Diego Avenue, as the bottom of this plaque maps out. If you look closely, you may find the markers on the street and sidewalk. One of the original headstones belongs to Rosa Serrano de Cassidy. It mysteriously says she died September 1869, but the records show she was buried, in fact, 7 months earlier. Like the Whaley House, El Campo Santo is known to have spiritual activity. True or not, it is interesting to see it in Old Town. Old Town is historic San Diego, and also a tourist destination of shops with many souvenirs for purchase. There's the Old Town Market, with many shirts and clothes on display here. The Fiesta de Reyes, with its merchandise and restaurants. There's even these decorative and festive figures created from flowers and foliage. Arts, crafts, and gift shops line the outer edge of the Fiesta de Reyes. seating for the main restaurant takes the majority of space in the center plaza. There are colorful art pieces throughout, like these musicians, more flower figures, a vivid vase and tile display, and a wooden carved horse. There are stands at Casa de Equire selling ukuleles, luchador masks, phone covers, and handmade jewelry. You can also catch an Old Town trolley tour to explore San Diego from here. If you enjoyed this video, please support this channel. Thanks for watching San Diego Review.